Good afternoon, everyone. So today we will continue with our subject, and we are going to look at a new topic, and that is e-procurement. In a way, this is an extension of what we discussed last week. It's an aspect of supply chain management, but given the strategic importance of procurement that today many companies consider, we will have a closer look onto that topic. So if we refer back to the value chain that we discussed last week, the original value chain that Michael Porter suggested was categorized into two types of activities, that is primary activities and support activities. If you look at those support activities, one of them is procurement. Now, traditionally, procurement has been regarded as not so important activity in an organization. It has been often regarded as an anonymous or invisible activity within an organization, mostly as an administrative or clerical task within an organization, in the sense that it was not regarded as a value creation, as a primary value creation activity. But many reports suggest that to a typical company, procurement costs can represent anywhere between 50% to 75% of annual revenues of a company, which means if you are able to reduce even a small portion of that, that could result into significant results. And we will see some examples later. There was a report by Arbiden Group which found that it would take a $5 increase in sales to equal the impact of $1 reduction in procurement costs. And all these reports have been trying to emphasize the importance of procurement function within an organization.